Good morning students, good morning to all of you. So today we are going to discuss about construction of parabola by eccentricity method. This is unit 1 class 7, main topic name conic sections. So listen carefully. Today in this class we are going to discuss about these topics. They are parabola, what is parabola, how can we get the parabola, what is conic, how can we define conic, general diagram of ellipse, parabola, hyperbola, practical applications of parabola, construction of parabola by eccentricity method or focus directrix method or general method. So these are the topics we are going to discuss in this class. So before that, already we have discussed about conic sections. So how can we get the conic sections? So depending upon the position of the cutting plane, we have four types of conic sections. They are circle, ellipse, parabola, hyperbola. So these are the conic sections. So let us see parabola shape. How can we get the parabola? So already we have discussed in the previous class or previous video. See, this is a right circular cone. This is the right circular cone. See, this is a generator. This one is axis of the right circular cone. See here, this one is parabola, ellipse, circle, and this one is hyperbola. See here, how can we get the parabola shape? If we cut the right circular cone with the help of cutting plane, see, when the cutting plane is parallel to one of its generator, then the obtained section is called what? Parabola shape. Okay, see here. So this is a CC is nothing but cutting plane, CC cutting plane. So here this CC cutting plane is parallel to this generator. This is a generator. So when the cutting plane is parallel to one of its generator, so then if we cut this right circular cone like this, so then the obtained section is called parabola, parabola shape. Once again, listen, what is, how can we get the parabola? If we cut the right circular cone with the help of cutting plane CC, when the cutting plane is parallel to one of its generator, the cutting plane should be parallel to one of its generator, then the obtained section is called parabola. So for parabola, eccentricity is equal to 1. So this is a right circular cone. So we are cutting this right circular cone with the help of cutting plane CC. So this is the cutting plane. This is the cutting plane. This rectangular shape is the cutting plane, CC cutting plane. Means it acts as a knife. Okay, by using this we are cutting. Okay, by using this CC cutting plane we are cutting the right circular cone. So here the condition is what? This cutting plane is parallel to one of its generator, so then the obtained section is called what? This is a parabola shape. Okay, next, see here, this is a cutting plane. This is a cutting plane representation, line representation. So this is parallel to, this is the generator of the right circular cone. These two are parallel. So if we cut this right circular cone with the help of cutting plane, and the cutting plane is parallel to one of its generator, then the obtained section is called, this is a parabola shape. Next, topic conic. So what is conic? How can we define conic? So conic is nothing but what? Conic is nothing but curve. This is a curve. This is a curve. Conic or curve, both are same. So conic is nothing but what? Curve. So how can we define conic? Conic is defined as the locus of a point. This is a locus of a point. Okay, the locus of a point moving in a plane such that the ratio of distance from the fixed point to, sorry, this is a fixed point. Distance from the fixed point to fixed straight line. This is a fixed straight line. Always constant. Always constant. So here this fixed straight line is called, fixed straight line is called directrix. So this fixed point is called focus point. So how can we define eccentricity? How can we define eccentricity? Means it is the ratio of distance of the point from the focus to, from here, this focus point to, distance from the focus point to distance from the directrix. Distance from the, this is a focus point, this is a directrix line. So distance from the focus point means this distance PF distance. Distance from the focus point to distance from the directrix, this distance. So that is eccentricity. Once again, listen, how can we define eccentricity? Means it is the ratio of distance from the focus point to distance from the directrix. That is called eccentricity. It is denoted by small e. So eccentricity value for parabola e is equal to 1. For ellipse, e less than 1. For hyperbola, e greater than 1. So this is about conic. Next, the general diagram of ellipse, parabola, hyperbola. So next topic is general diagram. This is general diagram of the ellipse. Already we have discussed. This is a general diagram of the parabola. Okay. So for parabola, eccentricity e is equal to 1. For ellipse, e less than 1. For hyperbola, e greater than 1. So eccentricity is nothing but what? See here, eccentricity, the distance from the focus point to distance from the directrix line is called eccentricity. So from the focus point distance. So this is a locus point moving in a plane. The P is nothing but locus point moving in a plane. So fixed point distance to fixed straight line distance always constant. That is eccentricity. Okay. So here, this is a general diagram of the parabola. This is vertex point. So what is vertex point? How can we define vertex point? Vertex point. How can we define vertex point means? So V represents vertex. How can we define? So the point vertex may be defined as like this. The point where the conic cuts its axis. Conic is nothing but, already I have said, conic is nothing but curve. This is curve. The point where the conic cuts its axis. So here this conic is cutting the axis line at this particular point. That particular point is called vertex point. Once again, listen, definition of the vertex. Once again, listen, definition of the vertex. The conic, the point where the conic cuts its axis, the point where the conic cuts its axis is called vertex point. This is a vertex point. So this is a vertex point of the parabola. This is a vertex point of the hyperbola. And this one is vertex point of ellipse. Okay. So this is a directrix line. Vertical line is called directrix line. Horizontal line is called axis line. Okay. So this is a general diagram of ellipse, parabola, hyperbola. Next topic is practical applications of parabola. So engineering applications of parabola. The parabola shape is used in the construction of light reflectors, in the construction of sound reflector, in the construction of arches, in the construction of bridges, etc. So these are the some of the practical applications of the parabola shape. So in the construction of bridges, parabola shape bridges, so we use generally, and in the manufacturing of light reflectors. So this is a bridge, parabola shape bridge. Right, light reflectors. So these are the light reflectors. These are the some of the practical applications of the parabola shape. So parabolic supporting cable, parabolic shape. This one is sound reflector. This is also in the parabola shape. So these are the some of the practical applications of the parabola. Already we have discussed in the previous class. So let us see next topic, methods of parabola. So methods of parabola. So following methods are used in the used to construct a parabola. So generally we have four methods for constructing the parabola. Generally we have four methods for constructing the parabola. They are eccentricity method or focus directrix method. Second one, rectangle method. Third one, parallelogram method. Fourth one, tangent method. So according to, but our syllabus point of view, we have only one method, that is focus directrix method or eccentricity method or general method. We have only one method. So let us see about the focus directrix method. See here, focus directrix method or eccentricity method, problem will be like this. So draw a parabola by using eccentricity method or focus directrix method or general method. When the distance between focus point and a directrix line is given, that is 40 mm, and also draw tangent and normal line at any point on the parabola curve. So this is a question. What is the given data? Focus point distance is given. Focus point distance is given, that is 40 mm, and also eccentricity value. What is eccentricity value for parabola? So eccentricity value is equal to 1 per parabola. So we can write it as E is equal to 1 by 1 means that is also 1. So I am writing like this. E is equal to 1 by 1 means 1, that one also 1. Okay, so eccentricity value is 1. Focus point distance from the directrix line is given, that is 40 mm. This is a given data. So after solving this problem, we will get the answer like this. This is a final answer. So red color shape is parabola shape. This one axis line, green color is tangent, and this one is blue color is line is normal line. So let us see the construction procedure of the parabola. Construction procedure of the parabola. See, first we need to draw any vertical line as a directrix. Draw any vertical line DD as a directrix line. Second point, mark a point C on the directrix line. Mark a point C on the directrix line. Third point, from the point C, draw the axis line which is perpendicular to axis line. From the point C, draw the axis line which is perpendicular to directrix line. And fourth point, mark a focus point on the axis line such that CF is equal to 40 mm. CF is equal to 40 mm. This is fourth point. And fifth point, divide the CF into two equal parts. So why we have to divide this CF into two equal parts? In case of ellipse, so we have divided this CF into 5 number of equal parts because of it depends on the eccentricity value. So here eccentricity value of parabola is equal to 1. So means we can write it as 1 by 1. So numerator 1, denominator 1. If we add these two, we get the 2 value. So that's why we have to divide this CF into 2 number of equal parts. Sum of numerator and denominator of eccentricity. 1 by 1 means we get the 1. Okay, 1 plus 1 is get the 2. Okay, so that's why we have to divide this CF into 2 number of equal parts. And sixth point, mark the vertex point at midpoint. So eccentricity value is equal to 1. That's why we have to mark the vertex point at midpoint of the CF. Okay, seventh point, from the vertex point B, draw the perpendicular line, that is VB, such that VB should be equal to VF. So join CB and extend it. Join CB and extend it. So from the vertex point, from the vertex point B, mark the approximately equal parts on the axis line, say 6 or 7. As your wish, you can take 6 points or 7 points as your wish. Next, 8th construction point, draw the perpendicular lines through the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, these lines means these perpendicular lines will meet the CB line at 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, 6 dash, 7 dash. Okay, next, F1, F as center, 1-1 dash as radius, draw two arcs on both sides of the line, axis line. So these are intersect at point P1 and P1 dash. Okay, next, repeat this procedure for all radius 2-2 dash, 3-3 dash and so on. So we get the intersecting points P1, P2, P3, P4 and so on, P6 and P1 dash, P2 dash, P3 dash, P4 dash and so on, P6 dash. Okay. So if we draw a smooth flow, if we draw a smooth curve through the points P1, P2, P3, P4, P5 and so on, P6 and P1 dash, P2 dash, P3 dash, P4 dash and so on, P6 dash. So that is the required parabola. So this is the construction procedure. According to this construction procedure, so how can we draw the parabola shape? So let us see. Okay, students, so according to this construction procedure, so how can we draw the parabola shape? Means, see, let us see how to draw the parabola by using focus directrix method or eccentricity method or general method. So this is a construction procedure. See here, the first point. What is the first point? First, we need to draw any vertical line. As a directrix line. So this is our directrix line. This is a vertical line. First, draw any vertical line DD as a directrix line. So this is a directrix line. So on this directrix line, mark a point C. C at anywhere on this directrix line. On the directrix line, mark a point C. So I am marking this C point at this particular position. Okay. So from this third point. So from point C, draw axis line which is perpendicular to your directrix line. See here. So from the point C, this is a point C. So from that point C, draw the axis line. Axis line should be like this. Dash dot, dash dot, dash dot, like this. Okay, from point C, draw axis line. This axis line should be perpendicular to directrix line. Okay, so that is the third construction point. Fourth point. What is the fourth point? Mark the focus point on the axis line. Mark the focus point on this axis line such that focus point distance is given how much? 40 mm. See, so this is the focus point F. So what is the distance of this point? Focus point distance 40 mm from the directrix line. So mark the focus point on the axis line such that CF is equal to 40 mm. Okay, this is a 40 mm distance, 4 centimeters. So fifth point, divide the CF into two number of equal parts. Divide the CF into two number of equal parts. Divide this CF into two number of equal parts. Why? Because eccentricity value, what is eccentricity value? E is equal to 1 by 1, that is equal to 1. Okay, 1 by 1 means that is also 1. So here, if we add the numerator and denominator of the eccentricity, we get the 2. So that's why we have to divide this CF into two number of equal parts. So here, this is a focus point F at a distance of 40 mm from the directrix line, and this is a, we have to divide the CF into two number of equal parts. Why? Because eccentricity value of the numerator and if we add the numerator and denominator of the eccentricity, so we get the 2. So divide the CF into two number of equal parts. Next, sixth point. What is sixth point? Mark a vertex point at midpoint of CF. So we have to mark the vertex point at midpoint, of the CF distance. What is the CF distance? 40 mm. So at 2 cm distance, we have to mark vertex point V. Okay, that is a point C, point 6, point 7. Construction procedure 0.7. What is the 0.7? From the vertex point V, draw the perpendicular line VB such that VB is equal to VF. See here. This is a vertex point. From the vertex point, we draw the one vertical line. This line should be perpendicular to your axis line. So this is a VB line. So what is the distance of the VB? Means VF, VB should be equal to VF. VB should be equal to VF. Okay, that is the seventh point. And join C and B. Join C and B and extend it like this. Join C and B with help of scale. Join C and B and extend it like this. Okay, so that is the seventh point. And the eighth point, from the vertex point V, from the vertex point V, mark approximately equal parts. Mark approximately equal parts on this axis line. So say 6 or 7. So this is first point 1, this is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I am taking 6 points. So name them 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So So this is the seventh point, or sorry, eighth point. So what is ninth point? So from these points, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So from these points, draw the perpendicular lines. So from point 1, draw one perpendicular line. From point 2, draw another perpendicular line. So similarly, from point 3, point 4, 5 and 6, draw the perpendicular lines from point 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is the ninth construction point. And tenth construction point, what? So these perpendicular lines will meet the CB line at point 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, and this one is 6 dash. Okay. Now 1 dash as radius with the help of compass, one one dash as radius. F is the center. Focus F is the center. Draw two arcs on both sides of the axis line. So this is your axis line. For this axis line, draw the arcs on both sides of the axis line. See here once again, 1 1 dash as radius. Focus F is the center point. Draw two arcs on both sides of the axis line. Okay. And repeat this step. Repeat this step for all radius 2 2 dash, 3 3 dash, 4 4 dash. So we get the arcs like this. 2 2 dash as radius, draw the arcs. 3 3 dash as a radius, F is the center, draw arcs. 4 4 dash as a radius, F is the center again, F is the center, draw arcs. And 5 5 dash as a radius, F is the center, and 6 6 dash as a radius, F is the center point, draw arcs. So this is P1, this is P2, P3, P4, P5, P6, P1 dash, P2 dash, P3 dash, P4 dash, P5 dash, P6 dash. These are the intersecting points. So after getting P1, P2, P3, P4, P6 and so on, P6, P1 dash, P2 dash and so on, P6 dash, draw a smooth curve, from the vertex point. So from start from vertex point, so draw a smooth curve from the vertex point. You can get the parabola shape. This is a parabola shape. Draw a smooth curve from these points, starting from the vertex point. Okay, this is the parabola shape, parabola curve. Okay, so how can we draw the normal line and tangent? See, take any point on the parabola shape. So I am taking here, this is a point. Take any point on the parabola curve, this is a point. So this point name I am giving M. So join M and F, okay. So for this MF line, draw one perpendicular line. So here the angle should be, see, this is T point, this is a T point. TF, the angle between TF line and MF line should be 90 degrees. This is 90, it should be 90 degrees. Okay. So we get the T point on the directrix line here. So this is a T point. Join T point and M point with the help of scale like this. So this green color line is called tangent. This is your tangent. So for this tangent, draw one perpendicular line. So this is a black color line is normal line. So this is your normal line. Okay. I hope you understand. I will explain this parabola again with the help of drafter. Okay, student, we will see the next problem. Construct a parabola with the distance of focus from the directrix is 50 mm. Also draw normal and tangent to the curve at a point 40 mm from the directrix line. So this is another problem. So let us see how to construct a parabola by using focus directrix method or eccentricity method or general method. Okay, this is another problem. So I will explain the construction of parabola by using focus directrix method with the help of drafter. So all of you listen carefully. Okay, see here, first draw a axis line, horizontal line. So first draw a horizontal line. So that is your axis line. AB is the A. This is a point A and this is a point B. This is your axis line. So here draw the directrix line. Draw the directrix line. Okay, this is a draw the directrix line CD or DD, whatever it is. This is your directrix line. Mark a focus point. So focus point distance is given, that is 50 mm from the directrix line. So mark a focus point F. Divide the AF into two number of equal parts by using line dividing method. Already we know the how to divide a line into two number of equal parts by using line dividing method. So this is a line dividing method. So mark a point, midpoint V. So this is your vertex point. From that vertex point, draw the VE line. VE should be equal to VF. Okay, join A and E. Join A and E and extend it. Join A and E and extend it. So from the vertex point, mark the approximately equal parts. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this. So from these points, draw the perpendicular lines. So draw the perpendicular line through the point 1. Draw the another perpendicular line from the point 2. So these line meets AE line at 1 dash, 2 dash, like that. And draw the another perpendicular line through the point 3. And also draw the perpendicular line through the point 4. So this will meet your AE line at point 4 dash. And also draw the perpendicular line through the point 5. So this line will meet your AE line at particular point, that is 5 dash. Okay. So now with the help of compass, take 1 dash as radius, F is a center, draw two arcs on both sides of the axis line as shown in this video. And similarly, this is your P1 and P1 dash. Similarly, 2 dash as a radius, F is a center, draw the two arcs on both sides of the axis line. You will get P2 and P2 dash. And similarly, 3 dash as a radius. Again, F is a center. Cut the third vertical line, third perpendicular line. You will get P3 and P3 dash. P3 and P3 dash. And similarly, 4 dash is a radius. F is a center. F is a center. Again, draw the arcs. You will get P4 and P4 dash. P4 and P4 dash. And lastly, 5 dash as a radius. Again, F is a center. Draw another two arcs on the fifth perpendicular line. You will get P5 and P5 dash. Draw a smooth curve through these points. P1, P2, P3 and so on. P5, P1 dash, P2 dash, P3 dash, P5 dash. So you will get the red color line is parabola shape. So for drawing the normal and tangent, mark a point at 40 mm distance from the directrix line. So this is your M point. Join M and F. Okay. For this M and F line, draw the perpendicular line. It will meet your directrix line at point T. So join T and this is starting point M. So join T and M. That is a green color line. So that is your tangent. So for the tangent, draw the perpendicular line. So now this is your normal line. Okay. I hope you understand. Thank you. Thank you so much.